you.
My goodness. Who would have thought that such a rare butterfly could exist in this tin cocoon?
Hey, for your information, plenty of refined, sophisticated women ride the bus.
Open your eyes, Nimrod! That was my stop!
By the way, I'm out of cash. I need something to tip your garage attendant.
Oh, great. What? These pills.
Well, I was thinking money, but you know him better than I do.
No, it's not a good time.
But it's getting spooky over at Niles's.
Well, yes, I know it's a little unsettling the way he changes into that Chinese dressing gown after dinner, but you'll get used to it. Go on.
Okay, Kemp's passing me the ball. Mm-hmm. I'm bringing it up court. Mm-hmm. I'm dribbling.
Don't worry about your appearance.
Oh, hey, who's this little guy?
I'm not sure I even know anymore.
Oh, my dad's getting the same way.
Join me, Frasier. I'll make your dreams come true.
At what cost?
Hi-ho! I'm Nigel's brother, Cedric. I haven't seen him since our boyhood.
And so died the last surviving member of the first ever family.
Next. Next. Oh, Shark Week. Addies.
I know you're there.
Man! Let's see. Icy cold man. Ice man. Got it!
Thank you!
Frosty the Snowman!
Yes! Oh, you jackass! The Iceman cometh!
Disqualified!
I usually hate these kinds of parties.
Oh, me too. People are always so superficial.
Yeah. Seems like everybody nowadays is all about appearances. Mm-hmm. Well, should we get a drink?
Yeah, sure. I'm not really very thirsty.
Me either.
Okay, see ya.
You used to think my accent sounded musical, didn't you, Marty?
Yeah, but now I'm used to it.
I'm not going to give you anything to eat. Oh, all right, here, you might as well finish off this god-awful shepherd's pie that Daphne made. Lord knows it isn't fit for humans.
You two are the worst charades players I've ever seen in my entire life. My God, those skating chimps got... Well, you did your best. We'll get it next time. Off I go.
So, what are you reading?
It's my Bible. The Big Book of Barbecue by Jeff Felgo. He's a Texan. You know, of course, all Texans think they invented barbecue. Arrogant bastards.
Well, maybe we could take in a Seahawk game sometime. Frasier hates us, or it'd just be us.
Hey, Frasier warned me about you.
Come, Frasier.
You know, in Japan, they call their barbecues hibachis, the arrogant bastards.
They're so delicious, I've already had three. Mm. This is my last little man, I promise.
Oh, Gil, who are you kidding?
No one, Gil.
I can't!
Sort of violent accident.
Violent, yes. But an accident.
Murder. Murder most foul. The darndest thing. Every year when I take him out of the box, something's wrong with him, but I always manage to fix him again.
Well, good for you, Dad. I told you to dunk it underwater.
I did.
Are you happy? You killed Eddie's little friend, poor little guy.
And what should we do, just kick him over the edge?
You know the old caution. Champagne after sherry makes tummy grow wary.
You have your brother's wit, sir.
Our carriage waits.
And you better get home at a decent hour. I'm going to be waiting up for you.
Mr. Crane.
Evelyn, and buy a bar of lavender soap just to be safe.
Sit down. Lavender soap, for God's sakes, you're a man. You'd look ridiculous.
May I get your drink?
Fuzzy navel blended nice and frothy, please.
It's as if that panhandler I gave money to was a genie granting all my wishes.
Would you marry me in this?
How much did you give?
Disgusting, you filthy thing. Get out of here right now. Get out!
Gary, I'm so sorry.
Fine. I will arrange an introduction to my sweater weaver.
Good. Thank you.
But then I must insist on the formula to your bath blend.
I think we were closer on an earlier draft.
Concur. The rest is...
silence.